Well, hi there, everybody, and good morning to meteorologist Travis Klineski here on this Thursday morning. We are seeing clouds and already a little snow in the panhandle of Nebraska. Clear skies to the east. Cloud cover is going to thicken up from west to east during the morning hour. So if you want sunshine, enjoy it this morning because it will become rather cloudy by later today. Eastern Nebraska will still enjoy a little bit of sunshine, but the farther west you go, the thicker the clouds will be. Lighter winds for many of us in the eastern half of the state as they'll be kind of out of the north and the northeast. But out west, they're going to turn more east and southeasterly, and they'll be a bit breezy out there in southwest Nebraska and into the panhandle. And those are areas in the panhandle, I'll back this up again, is that it's already snowing in some spots. That snow will try to change to rain if it can warm up enough later on today. But the majority of the moisture staying west of Highway 83, so most of us won't see much out there for today. But it will spread eastward this evening. Initially, it will be rain that spreads eastward into central Nebraska, maybe eastern Nebraska late in the night and into tomorrow morning, but before midnight, not eastern Nebraska. But out west, by midnight, we may start to see snow move into the western parts of the local four viewing area, possibly as far east as Highway 183. That's the highway from Valentine to North Platte to McCook. But a better chance of that snow spreading eastward after midnight tonight. So moisture continues moving eastward. You'll notice higher chances, better likelihood, heavier moisture the farther southwest you go, lower chances, lower moisture the farther northeast you go. Now here in the Tri-Cities, we could get cold enough to mix in and maybe throw in a little snow here in those areas, but accumulation is going to be tough to come by. Meanwhile, the better chances of accumulating snow will be west of Highway 183, especially on grassy surfaces. The concrete surfaces, it may melt a little quicker and maybe don't see as much accumulation there, but grassy surfaces, elevated surfaces may pick up on some accumulating snowfall. That snow and rain continues into tomorrow morning, but then kind of for those that see snow, changes back to rain as it warms up during the day. A somewhat breezy north and northeast wind. We'll keep the moisture going into Friday night, but it really winds down during the evening, so just slim chances after midnight. And while, yes, it could start to mix with snow again by late in the night and into Saturday morning, by that point there will be such limited moisture, I would not expect much additional accumulating snowfall in any areas out there into Saturday morning. So let's look first off at the rain forecast, and this is rain plus liquid equivalent precipitation. So basically, if you take the areas that do receive snow and melt it, this is the amount of moisture that you would get. We could see some decent totals, some places a half inch and more in the south and the west. Some places maybe over an inch of liquid precipitation. Meanwhile, farther north and east, not as much expected in those locations. But of course, like I said, some of this will fall as snow, and so we'll have to watch for that snow accumulation, like I said, especially on grassy surfaces. Now, Tri-Cities area, I think our amounts will be very limited at best. Yes, we may see some flakes fly, but it's falling on temperatures that are at the surface going to be near or above freezing. Plus, it's falling on wet surfaces because of the rain prior to it. So a lot of that snow will hit the water on the ground and melt. So I'm not expecting much moisture or at least snowfall totals in the Tri-Cities. But get west of Highway 183. That's the north-south highway there that divides the state in half. West of Highway 183, that's where you start to see accumulating snow. 1, 2, 3 inches of snow, maybe 4 inches of snow farther west, possibly 5, 6 inches into the panhandle of Nebraska. So higher amounts the farther west that you go. And this is all good news, though, as the moisture is falling on areas that need the moisture the most. The drought monitor, which will come out updated here in a few minutes, in fact, here after I'm recording this, I don't think it'll change too much, but you can see the western and southwestern parts of the state are the most desperate for additional moisture. So hopefully things are going to pan out for those locations. Now, temperatures later on today topping out. And actually, before I get to that, I do want to show one more thing here, and that is our winter weather advisory or winter weather alerts graphic. There are winter weather advisories starting at 1 a.m. tonight, 1 a.m. tomorrow morning, for areas near and west of Highway 83. Those are areas that would most likely see maybe 1 to 4 inches of snowfall. And then where winter storm warnings are in place, this is outside of the local four viewing area, we'd be looking at a 3 to 6 inch type snowfall in those locations. Now we'll move on to temperatures. For today, topping out only in the 30s in the panhandle, otherwise 40s out west, 50s to the east, low and mid 50s, and we'll struggle to 50 here in the Tri-Cities. Dropping back into the upper 20s and low to mid 30s overnight tonight and into tomorrow morning. Highs tomorrow will be in the upper 30s and low to mid 40s, so it's going to be a chilly day, maybe some upper 40s to near 50 way out east. But it's going to be chilly for everybody considering the time of the year. Tomorrow night as the storm system finishes up, we'll see a lot of 30s again, maybe near 40 out east in Lincoln and Omaha, some 20s out west. And then Saturday, slow recovery. mid to upper 40s and lower to mid 50s for high temperatures on Saturday. So again, chilly couple of days ahead, the coldest day tomorrow. Lots of moisture, especially Thursday night through Friday night, wrapping up early on Saturday. Very limited accumulating snow at best in the Tri-Cities area. After Saturday, we see a little bit of a warm-up, very temporary warm-up on Sunday with mostly sunny skies, lower 60s, and then here comes a strong cold front on Monday that comes plowing southward, bringing dropping temperatures. We'll see a high, if we're lucky, lower to mid-40s in the Tri-Cities, plus the winds are going to be strong out of the north. Could bring some afternoon rain that we'll try to mix with and change to snow Monday night into Tuesday morning. Not out of the question, we see some accumulating snowfall. We'll see how that plays out. By Tuesday afternoon, should be dry. A cool day on Tuesday, hoping to start to warm things up a little bit by Wednesday with mostly sunny skies returning. That may stall out a little bit late next week here by Thursday and Friday. There are some signs of maybe some more moisture that might keep us on the cooler side. So if we get to 60, I think on Friday we'll be lucky. But after that, we may start to warm things up into next weekend. Forecast models are kind of trending towards maybe some warmer weather near and after this 10-day forecast. So I want to thank you all for watching on this Thursday morning. Take care. Enjoy the day while we have it and while we stay dry out there, because, again, a lot of moisture coming in later on tonight. Take care and God bless. Bye.